Hello, and welcome to Home Performance Company Startup. My name is Eric Gans, and today I'm going to talk to you about the tools that you need to get started as a, an energy auditor. I mean, as a home performance contractor, everything starts with an energy audit. So in a sense, you know, it's sort of one and the same, but basically, I want to give you some tips on the things that you would need if you're thinking about going down this path. I think, you know, one of the things that occurred to me based on a conversation I had with somebody who was interested in getting into the program and I was talking to and I'm still talking to. And one of the things he said, he's like, you know, I've got to come up with like $10,000 to, you know, get all this equipment. And what I want to do is try to talk to you a little bit about what that means, what that investment, you know, is broken down to. And if you know what each part is a little bit, then it's going to help you see past the dollar figure and understand why you need to spend the money. All right, so let's go ahead and get started here. I want to get into the audit gear, and I'm going to start with that today. And then I think for the next episode, I'll talk a little bit about the personal gear. The audit gear is definitely going to be the lion's share of the cost to get into this, but it's definitely well worth it. So the first thing I want to talk about is one of the things we do as energy auditors is we measure airflow. And the most important thing we're measuring is the exhaust fan airflow. And that comes into play and is quite critical. But you might also find yourself in a situation where you need to measure airflow on returns or supply ducts for the HVAC system. I recommend a product made by a company called CPS, and it's called the Amb Easy Hood. And it's kind of nice. It has a little attachment that you can link up to your phone through Bluetooth. You get the app. And it takes a little getting used to, but once you get the hang of it, it works very nicely. The next tool you're going to need to have in your tool belt is a gas sniffer, along with a little bottle of confirmation bubbles. And what that is for is when you're running around in a house with natural gas and it's got a water heater and a furnace, you need to make sure you check all the accessible gas lines. And that's what the gas sniffer does. And if you find a spot where the gas sniffer starts to call out to you, hey, you know, you got a leak here, you just need to confirm that with the little substance, the soapy bubbles you painted on. And if you get the bubbles going, you kind of know that, yeah, you've got a confirmed gas leak. And you mark it with a little bit of blue painter's tape and you let the homeowner know at the end. The next tool you're going to need to have is a drill with a special bit. And the special bit, it's kind of like a cone shaped. It's very strong. I think it's made of titanium. I don't know the exact name of it, but it allows you to drill into the HVAC metal, into the different flue covers and the different flues so that you can stick the probe for the combustion analyzer into the quote unquote throat of the machine. So, you know, there's a lot to this, but these, I just want to give you some general ideas of what you're buying and why. So the drill is going to help you also get into crawl spaces, into attics, where sometimes the hatches are screwed in and you're going to need to be able to get in there quickly. And you want to have all those tools readily available. You can't really rely, you know, on the homeowner for that. All right. The next thing you're going to need is a combustion analyzer, which is what I just talked about. And that is a complicated machine, but in simple terms, it has a probe. I'd say about 12 to 16 inch long probe that you are going to, like I said earlier, put into the different combustion appliances throughout the house when and they exist. And you're going to analyze different things. And that's, again, requires training and you have to learn a little bit more about all this stuff. But that is what a combustion analyzer does. It's going to tell you the machine's CO. It's going to tell you a couple of other things, its efficiency. And it also is going to be used for gas ovens. We're going to be able to find out if the gas is, you know, running smoothly and or the oven is running smoothly and it's not kicking, you know, harmful CO into the house. All right. The next thing I recommend, and you could probably get away without it for a little while, is a thermal camera or a IR camera. I think I've used a Testo and I've also used a FLIR, and I think the FLIRs are nice. They come in a couple different levels. You have to do some research there. I once used a thermal camera on my phone, and it was, I think, when they just came out. This was actually back in 2018. Maybe they hadn't just come out, but I think they're a little better nowadays, 5 years later. But I personally use a handheld. I think it gives the best result. And it does come in handy mostly for me when there are areas around the house that the customer is interested in understanding that I can't get to. That's when I find the thermal camera to be most useful, and also to present a story when the temperature variances are, you know, conducive to it. In other words, if you live in an area where the temperature inside and outside is oftentimes the same, and then you have your seasons, the best time to use the camera, at least what I found, is going to be when you do have big temperature variances. So wintertime, summertime. And usually it's good to point problems out. For example, if you have a knee wall in a situation or a house where the insulation has fallen, then that's going to really show a very good illustration of how you're getting, you know, radiant heat through the wall in the summer, or in the winter it's going to be a cold spot, and it does present a good visual. But again, the most important thing as an energy auditor in my life, or the way that I see it, is that you should try to see everything you possibly can with your own eyes. So that's why you can probably get away without a thermal camera initially, but you are going to come up to houses where you're probably going to need it. So you want to get on that as soon as you can. All right. The next thing you need to have on you at all times when you go into a house with any type of combustion appliance is a carbon monoxide detector. And that is something that you wear on your person. And they're a little bit costly. And they're also quite costly to have them serviced, because I just got one serviced and it was a lot. But these are all important. I have had a situation, I will say, where I once was in a house and I had my carbon monoxide detector on, and I turned on the customer's oven to perform the test. And the one thing I remember from my training is that when the number on your meter hits 75, you've got to get the heck out of town or out of the house. And it was like the highest reading I'd ever gotten. It was over 20 or 30 or something like that. And it wouldn't have been obvious to me, but the meter started beeping real loud. So I opened the door and I was able to clear out the air and inform the customer that she had a big problem. And she was thankful, because she used the oven quite often and she didn't even know. So these are the kinds of things that we're doing out there as energy auditors. And that's why these tools are super important. Okay, the next thing you're going to need is a ladder. Obviously, you're going to have to get into attics, and just about every attic I get into, I need my ladder. Occasionally, you'll find you can get into an attic from a wall that's adjacent, usually in a split level, something like that, split level type house. But ladder, and I recommend the little giant. I think it's a 14 foot. I have found that to be perfect. I can't even remember a time that it didn't get the job done for me, and it fits right in my little SUV. Step stool. I think a step stool is really important, because you're going to get 9 foot ceilings where you're going to need to get up there and get readings on the exhaust fans. And you're going to need to maybe replace light bulbs depending upon where you live and what type of program you're in. And I find that having a step stool is really, really good. All right. And last but not least, and the lion's share of the cost for the audit gear is going to be the blower door kit. And I kind of went through this process recently where I got a blower door kit, and it was through the Minneapolis Blower Door Company. I think it's E-Tech or something like that. There are two companies out there, RetroTech, and I think E-Tech makes the Minneapolis blower door. And I probably should know this and maybe make sure I get it right when I'm talking about it, but I think I got it pretty close. But the point really I'm trying to make is that the kit itself, they usually come with, and I'm going to kind of go through this with you, the actual fan. So you have the blower door kit, which is a complete test. You get a fan, And the way that the blower door works, and you can watch, I have a video on this, but it has a frame that fits into a door. You could fit it into a window if you need to. And that comes as part of the kit as well. So you have the frame to hang the fan. And the frame itself comes in a nice canvas sort of carry bag with a shoulder strap. And the fan has a handle. And then you also get a nice bag with it as well. This is again the Minneapolis blower door. So I think I'm not sure how RetroTech works, probably similar. And you also have to buy the manometer, which the manometer, I recommend the digital one because it's a little bit easier to use. Not that, we want to take shortcuts, but it's really kind of cool and it works very well. And it just, I like it. So we won't get too far into that. But along with that, you get all the tubing that you need. So tubing, the reason that's important, not to get too far in the weeds here, but you've got to get different pressure readings, and these are all things you're going to learn if you do pursue this a little further. But the tubing comes with it, and the bag comes with it, and the controller, which the controller is going to turn the fan on and off. So there you have it. That's the blower door kit. It's a little bit the short version, but that is what we're talking about.